What is going on, y'all? This is John Alsace with the Face Mask Podcast, bringing you new fantasy content every day on our YouTube channel. So if you're not subscribed, please hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out. But without further ado, I want to get into today's topic, and that is tight end TJ Hockenson. That when drafted, he was drafted 8th overall in 2019 at 6'5", 251 pounds. He showed high-end athleticism by testing in the 88th spark percentile, ran a 4.7 flat. Athletically, he drew comparisons to Travis Kelce because of his physical nature in the run and pass games too. While he hasn't reached those levels of production yet, it's only his third year in the league, and last season, he finished tight end 5 in Dynasty in his second season. He's 24 years old, fresh off 723 yards and 6 touchdowns. And look at the landscape of the team this season. The team lost both outside wide receivers in Kenny Golladay and Marvin Jones and replaced him with Breshad Perriman and Tyrell Williams. Now they also drafted a route running savant, Amon-Ra St. Brown, in the draft, who should operate in the same areas of the field as Hockenson. But we're talking about Jared Goff at quarterback for this team as well. And short passes is all we should be expecting from this offense. With the Detroit Lions expected to enter 2021 with one of the weakest wide receiver cores in the NFL, TJ Hockenson is going to be the quarterback's favorite weapon this year. He's the longest tenured offensive skill position player in Detroit's offense. A league-leading 64.1% of the team's 2020 targets have been vacated, including half the targets from inside the 10-yard line. They also lost Danny Amendola, for whatever that's worth, too. And there was a recent report from in-house Lions reporter Tim Twentyman saying that he wouldn't be the least bit surprised if TJ Hockenson leads the team in targets, catches, receiving yards, and receiving touchdowns this season. He also went on to say in that same report that Hockenson and Jared Goff had already developed excellent chemistry in the red zone. Lions tight end coach Ben Johnson said in May, "Sky's the limit for TJ Hockenson in 2021. The coaching staff is all in on this guy. He's looking like the only real offensive piece in this offense outside of DeAndre Swift that is going to be available to new starting quarterback Jared Goff. We all know Jared Goff hyper-targeted the wide receivers running slant routes in recent years for the Rams. So those outside guys, it doesn't look like those guys are going to be super productive with this quarterback if we're going to go off of past production. He's going to hyper-target TJ Hockenson first and foremost in this offense, and then, to a lesser extent, Amon-Ra St. Brown. The outlook for Hockenson is bright, and I think with the Kyle Pitts ADP getting out of control, Hockenson is being drafted at a slight value right now. He has an ADP of 62. He's the tight end 5. Kyle Pitts ADP right now is 44, tight end 4. I think if we're going off of facts and not hype, those two ADPs should be flipped, but they're not. So right now, I'm 100% going in on Hockenson because I think he has just as much upside as the majority of tight ends being drafted ahead of him. In drafts where I miss out on Kelce, I'm happy waiting till that middle of the fifth round to snap Hockenson. He's going to be a target monster. We're talking about he could threaten to break the tight end's catches mark at the end of the season this year. Think about that. He's that type of guy. He's going to be walking into that type of role. And we always say that it takes tight ends a few years to really mature and get their feet under them at the position. This is literally his third season. And I'm going to say it again. He's the longest tenured offensive skill position player in the Detroit's offense. So as such, I'm all in on Hockenson in pretty much all format. You can find a way to get him in Dynasty, get him. But what do you guys think? Do you guys think I'm crazy for valuing Hockenson so high? Or do you guys think it's justified? I'm all in. Put your thoughts in the comment section below. My name is John Alsace. This is the Face Mask Podcast. Once again, bringing you fantasy content every day. Thank you for listening. Have a great day.